NewsCenter 11. Thanksgiving dinner is a smashing success.
The Radnor Actors Workshop production of The Matchmaker opened on Thursday. Hello, and welcome to this week's edition of NewsCenter 11. I'm Emily Endres.
And I'm Joe Dow. We'll have those stories and more later on in the show. But first, we have a special guest, Grandma Thornbury.
Hello, it's good to be back on NewsCenter in front of the bright lights. I'm here to talk a little bit about Thanksgiving holiday, which started back in 1492 when I sailed over with Christopher Columbus, who was one of my students. I actually taught him how to sail. I sailed over on the Santa Maria, you know, there was the Nina and the Pinta, and we sailed the ocean blue, and when we made it to what we thought was India, we really made it to a new land called America, and we met these very, very nice darker complexion fellows that hunted with spears and water buffalo, and we all sat down and we had a bit of a feast, and I cooked some mashed potatoes and sweet potatoes, and we even had some turkey. And that is how the Thanksgiving holiday was started, and even now, millions of years later, we still celebrate Thanksgiving, and I just wanted to add my 2 cents and wish everyone a very special Thanksgiving, and keep in mind the people who had the first Thanksgiving because they did it before you.
Well, thanks for the great story, Grandma, and happy Thanksgiving to you, too.
Bye.
In other news, on Wednesday, November 10th, several Radnor High School students and their parents and teachers traveled to New York City to see the musical Avenue Q on Broadway. The musical, which won the 2004 Tony Award for Best Musical, is a story of a young college graduate who moves to New York City and finds himself living with an interesting assortment of characters. Perhaps the most notable characteristic of Avenue Q is that the main characters are all puppets. Mrs. Christie and her Meistersingers were very excited to see this show because many of them are familiar with the soundtrack. Before the show began, the students enjoyed participating in a workshop with some of the actors and the show's author. Unfortunately, the Radnor attendees were late to the workshop because their bus had a flat tire and they had to wait almost an hour for a replacement bus to arrive. The students ate lunch at the Hard Rock Cafe before attending the show. As always, a good time was had by all.
We now go to our new cooking segment with Amy Wong and Emily Privette as they show us how to make our family favorites, tacos.
Hey, Emily.
Yeah?
You know what I always wondered?
What?
What's the difference between a soft shell taco, and a burrito?
I don't know. I'm hungry, though.
Me too.
Hi, I'm Emily Privette.
And I'm Amy Wong.
And we're here today at Taco Bell.
And we're here to determine what the difference is between a soft shell taco, a hard shell taco, and a burrito.
This is a question that's been on our minds, and we're also going to do a taste test.
We've got our order.
And we're going to try to determine what's the difference between a hard taco, a soft taco, and a burrito.
You guys are going to have a burrito, a taco, and a soft taco.
Although I don't think there was really that big of a difference to begin.
Making tacos is something you can do at home also. Okay, today we're going to recreate one of the things we ate at Taco Bell. It's really easy to do on your own. For the outside of the tortilla, what you put all the filling in is you can get either corn tortillas or you can get flour tortillas. A lot of people prefer the taste of a flour tortilla. The corn is more traditional, and it's got less of a smooth texture, and the corn is a lot healthier for you.
Okay, and the ingredients that we'll be putting in our tortilla is onions, tomato, cheese, and this is cheddar cheese, and this is lettuce.
And also, we're going to make a bean burrito, so you have your refried beans. It comes in a can. It's pretty easy.
Okay,
and then... So what you're going to do is you're going to grate the cheese and then dice all the ingredients. Shells before you roll them off because it makes them softer and they taste better. And then you can also do it with flour ones, which are the same thing, they're just bigger and will give you the same effect.
In the dictionary, definition of burrito is a flour tortilla rolled or folded around a filling, and the definition of a taco is a fried tortilla that is folded or rolled and stuffed with a mixture. So the difference is just that a taco has a fried tortilla, and a burrito does not.
This is Amy and Emily signing off.
Back to you guys. Thanks, guys. Maybe next week they'll show us what to do with those Thanksgiving leftovers. The RTEA is recognizing American Education Week by thanking Radnor Township School District's educational support professionals with breakfast trays, cookies, and donuts that are delivered to each building office in the district. Also, on Monday, November 22nd, the PTSA will sponsor the Italian Bistro for all Radnor High School's faculty and staff. This event, which will serve dinner and dessert, is to be held in the Radnor High School faculty dining room. Channel 11 extends our warmest thanks to everyone being recognized for their hard work and the people organizing these events.
Go get the burnt dinner off the stove, because we'll be right back after these messages.
Matchmaker, matchmaker, I'll bring the veil. You bring the groom, slender and pale. Bring me your ring, for I'm longing to be the envy of all I see.
Match making, chicken and tomatoes,
and love,
and an Ambrose Kemper, and Robin Hood.
Matchmaker, matchmaker, make me a match, find me a find, catch me a catch, night after night in the dark I'm alone, so find me a match of mine. Matchmaker, matchmaker, make me a match. Find me a find, catch me a catch. Night after night in the dark I'm alone. So find me a match of my own. Matchmaker, matchmaker, make me a match. Find me a find, catch me a catch. Night after night in the dark I'm alone. So find me a match of my own. Matchmaker, matchmaker, make me a match. Find me a find, catch me a catch. Night after night in the dark I'm alone. So find me a match.
Welcome back to News Center. November is Pancreatic Cancer Awareness Month. Pancreatic cancer is the fourth leading cause of death from cancer, but of the most prominent cancers, it is the least funded. On Friday, students wore purple to show their support for pancreatic cancer research. To further support research, purple ribbons are being sold in the Radnor High School cafeteria all month long. The ribbons are 50 cents each, but greater donations are gratefully accepted and much appreciated. All proceeds go to the Pancreatic Cancer Action Network to fund research and awareness.
We now go to Clare Mahoney and Rachel Sweeney with this week's Raiders on the Rise.
Hi, I'm Rachel Sweeney.
And I'm Clare Mahoney.
And this is Mike Jr. We're here with a special edition of Raiders Who Have Already Risen. We're here with the Mikes.
So, that's right.
Hi.
You know.
So,
straight up.
Clare with the first question.
So, what do you think a person needs to make a very successful The Mikes show?
You need to wing everything you do.
You need charisma.
You need music. Oh, clearly music.
You need to win. Win?
No. There's no winning involved. We win, but not because we try to win. It's just because we're winners.
I think you misunderstood me. Did you say win or another wing?
Wing, yes. Wing you need it. To wing everything.
They improvise everything
you need to
they
improvise
do.
Everything right. You do and be funny at it.
Funny, okay.
Oh my God.
And so, why did you guys decide to be the Mikes?
Really, NewsCenter just need a little bit of bam.
Really?
So, we took upon ourselves.
Wait, what did they need to, can you do that again?
Bam! We really thought that somebody needed to do that, and so we took it upon ourselves to spice up NewsCenter.
We already have Joe Dow as an anchor, but we really
Joe, come on out here, please.
Joe, what about
Hilary?
Come on!
Joe, yes!
This is a real
Roger
Raider.
Right here.
Joe, what does it take to be a good anchor?
Well, I guess I was just born with it.
Yeah. Born with the pizzazz to be an anchor.
He's
full of pizzazz. Look at him.
You're full of pizzazz.
He's pizzazz-erific.
What?
For me, it's a big part of my life. I work hard at it. I mean, news is really important to me.
I was sitting with him during lunch, and he just kept talking to me about how hard he needs to work this week. He needs to get this anchor.
There's a great bird ring.
You know, that's what Rachel and I do.
It's a huge responsibility to get information out to the people. It's a huge responsibility. And somebody needs to do it and do it so they listen. And so that's our job.
Because
people listen to us because we're funny.
I think that's we learned enough about the Mikes and Joe.
So you're Brian's little sister.
Yes, I am.
Sweeney. Shout out Sweeney. Shout out Sean.
Love Sweeney.
We will see you next week.
Born with great anchoring skills. At least they didn't have puppets this week. Thanks, Rachel and Clare. The deadline for children's gifts for the holidays has been extended. Proceeds go to Toys for Tots, so be sure to purchase gifts for the children on your shopping list and benefit this worthy cause. You can pick up informational flyers and order forms in the Radnor High School mailroom and faculty dining room. The deadline now is Tuesday, November 23rd. Please return all order forms and payments to Arsha Silipone. Don't miss out on the charitable opportunity.
We now go to Hilary Duchovnay and Diane Bizzaro with this week's Passion for Fashion. This week, they headed to a local thrift shop.
How do you try it on?
Okay. I like the texture. I really like it.
Ooh. That's hot.
How do you put it on? Is it a button on it?
Spin around. Oh wow.
Okay. Next, let's look around.
Sweaters are really big this season.
Sweaters.
Eyes.
can get a really cute look if you take a tie.
But you
put
get
it around your waist.
Look at this necklace that Hilary found. Move your hair, Hilary. She put it on twice, and it's only $4. Good
find. You can get a great price at the shops.
And you can make it as a bracelet, too, also.
Here's Diane wearing a fur caplet. Fur is very popular this year. This happens to be real fur, but you can also wear faux fur. And this outfit would be, it's very versatile. You could wear it with jeans, huge shoes, or just wear it with like a skirt or whatever.
It's only $15.
Only $15. It's very cute. Because we are living in the material. Upscale clothing and accessories.
Here are some really cute Miss 60 jeans.
For only $28. That's awesome.
So it shows you that you can still get the great designer names but not spend as much money.
Here's some great jewelry here. We have some really awesome chandelier.
Move your hand.
Chandelier earrings.
Wow, that's awesome.
Here we have some costume
Chanel
jewelry.
Action with the bag. Oh, look at these pins. That's awesome.
That's really cool.
There's a really cool bracelet down there. Tan bracelet. Pins, necklaces. This is really nice. That, like that bag.
Here are some really cool funky earrings with vibrant colors.
This is brilliant.
And they just would like make your day so much more cheerful. And other
make
people's.
Your day. And they have all these different kinds. Awesome.
A lot those of earrings, a lot of necklaces, you can layer them to make a really
look
cool
the
look.
People look here. At awesome.
Honey. Here's Diane in a really cool fur poncho.
Kind of confusing, but it's really pretty. Look at the inside.
It's a vintage.
A vintage.
It's vintage, which we're just informed. Because we are living in a material world.
Thanks, girls. Who knew I could wear my tie as a belt? On November 18th, Radnor held its annual Thanksgiving dinner. This year's event was particularly special as it was the 10th anniversary of the very first Thanksgiving dinner. The guest list included senior citizens from the Wayne Senior Center, members from the Greater Mount Vernon Church, located in Philadelphia, and Radnor High School volunteers. Parents and teachers also attended. Guests enjoyed entertainment from the Madrigals and the B-Sharps throughout the night. This event requires extensive planning and participation, and this year over 50 students helped set up the delicious feast that was enjoyed by all. So as Mrs. Wysocki would say, gobble gobble, and thanks to everyone that worked to put together another successful Thanksgiving dinner.
We'll be right back after these messages.
Imagine me and you, I do. I think about you day and night. It's only right to think about the girl you love and hold her tight. So happy together. If I should call you up, invest a dime, and you say you belong to me, and ease my mind. Imagine how the world could be so very fine. So happy together.
Give me an R.
What do you found?
What do you got, little fella? Drop it. Looks like someone's butt. Man, they probably lost it playing with their kids. Hey, leave it. Come on. Come on.
Welcome back to this week's edition of NEWSCENTER 11. We now go to Allie Wolfson and Heather Van Trieste, who will tell us the dangers of carrying those heavy backpacks. Heather and Allie?
Hello, I'm Allie Wolfson.
And I'm Heather Van Trieste.
Pursue randomness.
It's a growing problem among high school students.
Heavy loads are being imposed upon them, weighing them down.
Backpacks are a problem.
We are going to go throughout the school and find out just who these backpacks affect and what are the problems. People have to walk with their backpacks from class to class, all day, every day. Who knows what can happen? These poor, pathetic, pitiful souls.
She has scoliosis, and it makes it hard for her to carry around a backpack sometimes.
Yep. Hurts. Hurts a lot. I blame the teachers and the textbooks. It's not cool.
It's just not cool. It's just not cool.
I'm here interviewing Mrs. McFarland, the school nurse, about what happens when people carry backpacks that are too heavy. Mrs. McFarland, what are some problems that can arise from people carrying backpacks that are too heavy for too long?
Well, I have kids come to the health room and they complain of low back pain. And when you assess what might have been causing, where a sport they were playing or an injury, oftentimes I do find kids complaining that the backpacks they carry seem to be heavy. We'll weigh backpacks and they'll be 20, 25, 30 pounds. I've even had a child carrying one that was 41 pounds.
Allie and I are going to weigh our book bags and our techie's book bag just to see how heavy they are.
First, we will weigh Heather's backpack.
£13. Now we're going to weigh Allie's book bag.
My backpack is £16.
Now we're going to weigh Winnie, our techie's book bag.
Winnie's backpack is a whopping 26 pounds. Do you think this is acceptable? We don't.
Carrying weight like this on our back can lead to stress fractures, which would be in your spine. You have vertebrae, and the stress of carrying heavy weight like that could cause a hairline fracture that would cause pain. Also, in developing musculature students are still developing at this time, it can lead that low back pain and how you carry yourself due to the pain can affect your development and would lead to scoliosis as an issue.
Since the beginning of school, I've had this really heavy backpack, and at first I carried all my books around with me because I really don't have enough time to go in between classes to my locker. But by about, I'd say, the second week of school, I really started having terrible problems, and my bio teacher said I wouldn't have to bring my textbook, but I still have to bring this huge, heavy math textbook, so we had to go to the doctor's and actually get a note so that I could have two textbooks, one for home and one for school. So, yeah, this has been a really bad problem.
So we would highly recommend that students not carry really heavy bags. It would be nice if you ideally could go to your locker and carry a couple books and notebooks at a time, and then go to your locker and exchange those books for other ones so you're not carrying all 8 periods throughout the day. But students often complain that there's not enough time to change classes in between, and because of that, they'll carry their subjects for the day. So another solution would be to carry a rolling book bag that totally takes the stress off your back if you can't get to your locker in between. So that's what I would recommend to our students. And if students continue to complain of back pain, we've talked about some adjustments with their book bag or suggesting a rolling book bag. We certainly would also recommend that they check with their family doctor to see if they need any follow-up care. Thank you.
Thank you very much. So there are clearly problems that come from backpacks. The school nurse gave us some suggestions of how to fix this problem, but will those suggestions really help? And can students really use those suggestions in their environment? Will teachers ever give us 2 sets of books to relieve the stress on our backs? Nothing is for certain. The only thing that we do know is that scoliosis braces may become much more common.
This is Heather and Allie for Sheer Randomness. Now back to you.
So that's why my back hurts. Last week, you heard all about Radnor Actors Workshop's fall production, Thornton Wilder's comedy, The Matchmaker. The play opened yesterday, Thursday, November 18th, but you can still come out and see the show tonight, Friday, November 19th, and Saturday, November 20th. Showtimes are 8 o'clock Friday and Saturday night, and there is also a 2 o'clock matinee. The show will be performed in the Radnor High School Black Box Theater. We are now excited for you to all come out and see the show.
There's a craft festival this Saturday, November 20th, at the Radnor Middle School from 9 a.m. to 3 p.m. If you can make sure to stop by, it'll be great. And on a different note, Radnor High School will experience a 3-hour planned power outage on Friday morning, November 26th, in order to work on repairs to the electrical system. Channel 11 will be out of service during this time, but hopefully our programming will resume after the repairs are completed. Unfortunately, however, our informational scroll will be unable to resume until the staff returns to school Monday, November 29th. We'd like to thank the community in advance for their understanding of this process. We'd also like to congratulate the boys' soccer team for making it to the state finals at Hershey this Saturday. Good luck, guys. Well, that about wraps it up for this week's edition of News Center 11. I'm Joe Dow. And thanks to Matt, Zach, Rachel, Claire, Hilary, and Diane.
And I'm Emily Endres. Make sure to tune in to Channel 11 over the Thanksgiving holiday as the LM Pep Rally will be played, and it won't be one that you'll want to miss. Have a good week.
What are you going to be thankful for this Thanksgiving?
You know what? I'm thankful for food, shelter, my family.
Well, I mean, that's all important, but you, as well as all of our viewers, should be thankful that I'm an anchor this year, and none of this is getting on TV because of this. Why
that was so good.
It was good.